Hello everyone, in this video I'll be discussing about the switching surges. You know, switching surges is one of the reason for internal cause of overvoltage. We have discussed what are the main causes of overvoltage in the previous session. Let us discuss a few details about switching surges. First and the foremost, let us understand the definition of switching surges. What do we mean by switching surges? A switching surges is a short duration transient voltage produced in the system due to a sudden opening or closing of a switch or a circuit breaker or an isolator or due to an arcing of the fault in the system. Majorly, switching surges are causing due to opening and closure of switch gears, especially circuit breaker, isolators, etc. The specialty of switching surges is it is having the short duration and also it is having the transient in nature. Okay. Moreover, the waveform, if I look at the waveform, it is having oscillatory nature. Okay. So it may be a damped oscillatory wave or whatever it may be. And also the frequency is in the range of a hertz to few kilohertz. That means high frequency. Moreover, if I talk about the nature of the switching surges and it is having just like an impulse waveform. Okay. Similar to impulse waveform. And the wave tail time that is equal to 10 milliseconds and the wavefront time is equal to 0.1 millisecond. Or else you can say that the wavefront time that is in the range of 0.1 to 10 milliseconds. This you can consider this as a wavefront time. You can call TF. TF is nothing but wavefront time, 0.1 to 10 milliseconds. If I talk about wave tail time, that is in another range. That means 1 to several milliseconds. Okay, so that is about the wavefront and wave tail time of switching surges. This is a general aspect. Let us define IEC, International Electrotechnical Commission standard, in the next slide. I'll be displaying that particular slide in front of you so that you will understand what is IEC standard or IEC definition of switching surges. Time being, you can understand that wavefront time that is in the range of 0.1 to 10 milliseconds and the wave tail time that will be varying from 1 to several milliseconds. And also it contains large energy. So these are the basic information about switching surges. Now we have to define based on IEC standard. So that's a standard definition. Okay, one of the Electrotechnical Commission power quality standard. Moving on to the further definition. So first let us define according to IEC standard, you can define the switching surges as the wavefront time that is equal to 250 microsecond. That is a wavefront time, where the wave tail time is equal to 2500 microsecond. If I add the tolerance, if I consider tolerance, the wavefront time that is in the range of 250 to 250 plus or minus 50 microsecond, and the wave tail time including tolerance that is in the range of 2500 plus or minus 500 microsecond. So this is a definition according to IEC. And moreover, if I talk about the switching surges, the overvoltage may go as high as 6 times of the normal power frequency voltage, almost 6 times you can imagine. That much of magnitude will be causing due to the switching surges. This much of magnitude will be produced. Then switching surges are the overcurrent or overvoltage. It may be overcurrent or overvoltage. Okay, in terms of voltage or current you can express. That spikes that are experienced in the highly inductive circuits at the time of sudden interruption. It is majorly concentrating at the high inductive circuits. As the magnetic field, the theory, as the magnetic field about the inductive conductor collapses, a brief, very high voltage can be generated at this point. This is a theory behind that particular, how the switching surges will be produced. You can underline the statement. As the magnetic field about the inductive conductor collapses, a brief, very high voltage can be generated at this moment or at this point. Okay, this is a basic information about switching surges. Now I would like to discuss the further details of switching surges. Remember the definition and the IEC. Based on IEC standard, how you can interpret or define the switching surges. Now let us note down what are the impacts of switching surges. The major impacts are shown below. It reason for overvoltage. Of course, almost 6 times voltage will be generated as compared to the normal voltage. If it is normal voltage is 400, you can imagine 400 times 6, that much of magnitude will be produced. Moreover, one of the internal causes, this is one of the internal causes of overvoltage. We have studied external causes as well as internal causes of overvoltage. And also they can damage the insulation or cause the flashover. And that is a damn sure that will definitely, that will take place. Then insulation failure will be occurred. Okay, definitely the insulation failure. If it is solid dielectric material, definitely permanent failure will be occurred. If I talk about liquid or gaseous dielectric material, the failure will be temporary. And it causes severe fire hazards. You must have remembered that I have displayed the diagram at the beginning of my slide. I have shown you one diagram. You can observe that definitely this causes fire hazards. Okay, these are the major impacts of switching surges. Okay, you can note down these points. Now let us discuss about the characteristics of switching surges. Before discussing the characteristics, let us find out what are the sources of switching surges. First in the foremost, de-energization of the transmission line, then cables, shunt capacitor banks, etc. Definitely that will be reason for the formation of switching surges. That's the first reason. Then disconnection of unloaded transformers and the reactors. Okay, that is also another reason. Then energization or reclosing of lines and reactive loads. That is also responsible for production of switching surges. Then immediate or sudden rejection of sudden turning of the load. If you remove the load immediately, sudden turning off or disconnection of the load, that is also causing of, that is also held responsible for the formation of switching surges. Then short circuits and fault clearances. Okay, it should take place in a certain time period, in a short duration. At that time, switching surges would be produced. During electric welding, then coupling capacitor voltage transformer, CCVT, operational CCVT, then gas insulated substation. These are another sources of switching surges, production of switching surges. Then resonance phenomenon like ferro resonance and arcing grounds, etc. also are held responsible for the production of switching surges. So these are the few things which we can explain the characteristics of switching surges. Now let us explain the characteristics of switching surges with the help of waveforms. These points you have to keep in your memory before explaining the characteristics of switching surges. Now I will be displaying you some waveforms. We can depict the characteristics of switching surges. See, these are the different cases when switching surges produces. Number one, recovery voltage after fault clearing. You can observe the graph, that means per unit value versus time. So this is the nature of the curve during recovery voltage after clearing of the fault. At the time of fault initiation, at the beginning of the fault, you'll be getting the waveform. So this is also one of the reasons for the formation of switching surges. And the third case, you can observe over voltage at the end line after the fault clearing. So waveform, we can see there is a negative peak as well. Okay, however, we can see the spike. Okay, immediate spike you can observe. Definitely at that point, we can explain about the formation of switching surges. There are two more cases left over. I'll be showing that cases also. See, energization of long transmission line. At that time, there will be negative as well as positive peak that is emerging out over here. Okay, that magnitude versus time graph is observed over here. And we can see the nature. Definitely, there will be high peak. Okay, so all units are expressed in terms of per unit, especially in the y-axis. Per unit is nothing but actual value to the base value, which is totally convenient if you express in terms of per unit. Similarly, over voltage at the end of the line, that is also observed in this manner. Okay, these are the different nature of switching surges. Okay, it varies from situation to situation. You can observe. So different, almost five to six cases I have already explained. Okay, from this you can observe that it varies, or the nature varies depends on the situation. Okay. Now, regarding extra high voltage and ultra high voltage, okay, you can inspect the reasons for the formation of switching surges in extra high voltage and ultra high voltage. The various reasons are given below. The first reason is interruption of low inductive current. That means current chopping. It is typically happening in case of air blast circuit breaker and air brake circuit breaker. And also you can expect some points in vacuum circuit breaker as well. So the current chopping by high speed circuit breaker. This occurs when the transformers or reactors are switched off. That is the first reason, especially happening in case of EHV and UHV system. The second reason is interruption of small capacitive current, such as switching off unloaded line. Okay, immediate switching, immediate removal of unloaded line. A third case, that is ferro resonance condition. So that is the third reason for the formation of switching surges. I'll be preparing a separate video on ferro resonance phenomenon in the next session. In case of ferro resonance condition, this may occur when the poles of a circuit breaker do not close simultaneously. Actually, pole should the pole of the circuit breaker should close at a time. If such cases are not happening, the Farrar-Russell phenomenon will be taken place. Because of that, switching surges will be generated. And the final case, the energization of long EHV or UHV lines. These are the major reasons for the generation of switching surges in case of EHV and UHV system. I hope you got my point. Okay, you can note on these points. Typically, it will be helpful for VIVAS, then some analysis. Okay. Let me ask one thing, how we can overcome the situation of switching surges, how to minimize switching surges. There are few methods to overcome the switching surges. They are given below. The number one, one step or multi-step energization of lines by pre-insertion of resistors. You have to design the value of resistor accordingly. You have to add those resistor values so that you can mitigate the problem of switching surges for certain extent. Moving on to the second method, phase controlled closing or circuit breaker with the proper sensors. Some electronic controllers are required. So by using that, you can mitigate the problem of switching surges for certain extent. Moving on to third method, drainage of trapped charges on the long lines before reclosing of the line. Okay, it is somewhat difficult. Third method is somewhat difficult actually, not viable. However, we can suggest this method. Moving on to the fourth one, limiting the over voltages by using surge diverters. This is a welcome, one of the best method among for usage of surge diverters. Okay, so you can minimize the switching surges, the effect of switching surges for some extent. You have to note on one point, the three methods, you know, these are the three methods. Okay, look at the three method. The first three methods, if you are using properly, will limit the switching over voltage to 0.5 to 2 per unit. Okay, because the magnitude I am expressing in terms of per unit only. So you can minimize that magnitude of voltage can be minimized in this particular range. Okay, so this is a peculiarity and these are the methods of minimizing switching surges. You can note down these methods. There are many more methods are available. So I have discussed only these methods which are most popular. Then let me ask one question. How do you produce switching surges for testing purpose? Anyway, you have to undergo the testing of equipments. You need to verify that whether the equipments like the transformers, then transmission lines, then other equipments will survive during the production of switching surges or not. We have to verify. For that purpose, we have to conduct testing. Okay, so we require the certain circuit. These circuits you can recall. That this is a modified form of impulse current generator. Okay, we have spear gap, then capacitors. We have during the charging and discharging the capacitors, we require a certain capacitor bank, and we need R1, R2 to control the duration of the waveform, because we need to verify that here test object is placed over here. CX means test object. Okay, here normally we are placing the test object. Okay, test object. These R1 and R2 that will be controlling the duration of the switching surge voltage, duration, time duration. Time duration will be controlled by the value of R1 and R2. So the G will be acting as a switch. Okay, then C1, that is mainly used for capacitor, it's a capacitor bank. So charging will be done serially, discharging will be done parallel. Okay, so we have already studied about the theory behind impulse current generator. This is a modified form of impulse current generator. And also we can say that this is another circuit. So here we are adding the inductance. Okay, so this is another way to produce the switching surges. Okay, these are the different methods. There are many more methods are available. So we can say that one of the methods, that is the modified impulse generator, can be used for production of switching surges. This will be really helpful for testing the devices. We have to check whether the device is fit for overcome the problem of switching surges. Definitely it will be taking place as an internal, one of the internal cause of overvoltage. And also one more method I would like to suggest to you, that Tesla coil. So that is another method, modified Tesla coil. If you design the Tesla coil in some certain manner, you can able to produce switching surges. And we can say that the condition for R1 and R2, see, R1 is about 20 to 30% of R2. Okay, that is another condition you have to remember. Similarly, the duration, if you select the value of R1 and R2, the duration will be like this only. See, 1000 to 100, 100 bar 1000 microsecond, or 400 bar 4000 microsecond. You can control by value of R1 and R2. For example, if you choose the range, the value of R1 in the range of 1 to 5 kilo ohm, you'll be getting the duration like this, 100 to 1000 microsecond. Suppose if you choose the value of R1 and R2 in the range of R2 in the range of 5 to 20 kilo ohms, then you will be getting the duration like this. Okay, so the as I already explained, the R1 and R2, that is really helping us to maintain the duration. Okay, time will be controlling R1 and R2. So this is the way how to generate switching surges, and this will really help us to conduct the testing. Okay, testing will be based on IEC, ANSI or IEEE standards. Okay, I have explained the testing also. You can visit the playlist of high voltage engineering. In this session, I have discussed about what do we mean by switching surges, and what are the characteristics of switching surges, what are the major sources of production of switching surges, and how to mitigate, how to overcome the switching surges, and how to produce the switching surges for the testing purpose. And I have referred the following textbook and websites also, various websites also. That information I'll be putting up in the comment box, sorry, in the description box. You can visit the description box to get the previous video link as well. Finally, thank you for paying the attention, and thank you very much for listening my videos.